Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Beautiful day to do a video of this 0232 Augusta. It's the Alpenlight, which was made up in Yakima, Washington. Unfortunately, one of the companies that went under during the recession that we went through. Aluminum framing, high gloss skin on the outside. Notice that sheen to this. It's a beautiful, beautiful, well-made fifth wheel. In the front here, I have the pass-through storage going through, and you can see it's quite a large storage area going up to the front as well. Looks like it does come with a portable satellite dish. I have a battery disconnect right here to my left to disconnect my batteries. We do have a 10-gallon gas electric hot water heater. Really, really nice. The gas electric will give you more hot water. That would really do well for my wife. Outside awning, and do notice it is an enclosed awning, which really helps protect that material underneath. Huge tires and wheels. I think there are 2, 4, 6, 8 lug. Very heavy duty axle. And folks, this just came in. So again, nothing's been done. We haven't touched it. We haven't detailed it. This is over in my area where everything first comes in. On the back end, I do have a luggage rack and ladder getting up on top. That's good for wanting to check your seals around your vents, air conditioning, that kind of area there. We have 2 slide outs, one in the living room, one in the bedroom, which we'll show you when we'll go in. Unfortunately, I don't have a key to this compartment, but this compartment goes in about that far. Great for a little bit of storage. Down here in the front, I have my 110, and this is 50 amp, folks. So I can go 50 to 30 if I need to, but with 50 amps, if you can get 50 amps, you can plug in about anywhere. Down here, I have my holding tank valves for my bath, my galley, and my black tank down here. And I do have a black tank flush right here. So rug goes in, squirts water all around, make sure no toilet paper gets stuck to the inside. Right in here, I have my couple propane tanks, and they are the newest style tanks with gauges on that one over there. So power on the front, I have the controls right here. Landing gear controls, I have my driver leg, I have my driver and passenger legs, and I have my passenger legs. So I can do them either individually. So if you're not quite level, you don't need to worry about putting a block under one of them because they will operate individually. So Curtis, let's go inside. We'll show them this great floor plan. These were very, very expensive in their time. Good, nice, quality, solid. At this point, folks, grab a piece of paper and a pen, because at the end of this video, you're going to get the information as far as contact, how to get a hold of me. Yes, and if you notice, I do have a little bit of British accent. Don't hold that against me. I am a true U.S. citizen, and I love to vote. So as you can see, lots of counter space over here. Nice stainless steel sinks. Wood plank floor going in. Big gas oven down below. Plenty of drawer space. Dinette will drop down and make into the bed. And then you have a sofa that makes also into the bed. Not that you'd want to sleep that many people. Look at that big window in the back, Curtis. Huge. Nice 2 leather recliners. Got jalousie windows, which I really like, because that way I can open the jalousie window, and on a day like today where it's partial sunny, partial rain, so I can let some air flow in here. Don't have to worry about if it rains or not. I'm going to scoot past Curtis here. Lots of storage down below. Very, very solid. We've got the Sharp carousel, big microwave oven, pantry that pulls out, large double door refrigerator. Notice they left some water in there already. Look at the skylight up above, bringing a lot of light into this area on a cloudy day. Ducted roof air conditioning up above. Got the old analog TV, which we probably should change out. if a person brought us a flat screen TV. And down below, we have a, is that a Pioneer? It's a Kenwood surround sound stereo system. Now I did notice that we have a inverter over here. It's a Zantrack, and I could guess, but normally these are about 2000 watt inverter. So that way, if I want to watch my TV, I can watch my TV right from my 12 volt battery system, because it's going through the inverter, converting 12 volt into 110 power. Let's go up in the galley area there. Solid hardwood cabinets. The bathroom is wonderful. It's a step-in shower with a china stool. Notice it's one-piece molded shower. Just shows you the quality of this Alpenlight fifth wheel. So not only do we have the double closet behind Curtis, but we have the full closet going across the front. And you're probably sitting there wondering how heavy this trailer is. So while Curtis is doing the video, it's 11,222 pounds dry. And we have a total of 110 gallons of fresh water on board. So folks, if you know quality, this is quality all the way through. One thing that Alpenlight did, and I'll just show you real quickly, Curtis, and that is we have a laundry chute right here. Goes right into that laundry basket on the outside, and then you can access your dirty clothes from the outside. Solid door will close off here, and solid door will close off here. So if you did have guests, you can slide the two doors, one into the bedroom, one into the living room. Folks, they don't come any better than this for quality. So if you are looking for a nice, clean, quality fifth wheel, this might be for you. I am Raymond Moore with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. We do thoroughly go through these things to make sure all is in good working condition. And then we give you a service mechanic that will go through it with you to show you how everything is in good condition. RV Corral is a great company. I can't say enough about them. Come and see me. Stop by. Email me. I'd love to visit with you, especially on this beautiful Alpenlight fifth wheel. Thanks for watching the video and have a great day.